everyone, and welcome to another episode of Schmidt Lavelle. My name is Tom Lavelle, and as always, I'm accompanied by Mr. Timothy Finn.
Tom, I got to ask you a question.
Yes.
Have you ever farted and then did one of these?
For those of you who are just listening, Timmy kind of turned his head back to behind himself, and it looked to me like he gave a little sniff, a little smell.
Hey, you ever sniff your own brand, Tom?
Of course. Of course I did.
You know, I mean,
it's funny that I guess your own farts, they don't smell to you. You know what I mean? It's not like, you know, they smell, but it's not like if it's someone else's farts, you could get sick. You could throw up. It would be awful.
Nah. When you got a good brain going, that's like, you know, when you're playing with fire, dude, you can start dealing that stuff out, dude. It's not good. Like you could be sitting in a room full of guys, and you know your brain is cooking, and you just let it rip. You start fading it out.
Oh my goodness! Awful. Go in the other room. Take a hike. Get outside. Go for a walk.
And all the boys are like, oh, come on.
Oh, what about if you're in a car, on a car trip or something like that? There's been some times where we had put all the windows down. We're in trouble here. You got someone dropping bombs. Interesting enough, I'll be going up to the Penn State-Washington game in about a month to see my first whiteout game. Never been to a whiteout game, Timmy, so I'm looking forward to that. Penn State currently ranked number 4 in the country, is that right?
Yeah, they're number 4. It's a little weird, though, the whiteout game. They don't let black people in.
Sounds like my type of game. you know what? I do have to...
can't sit here.
Yeah. Seat's taken. You know, thing with that is I have to buy, I guess, white clothing. I don't want to go in there and not wear, you know me, I basically wear all black. I'm always wearing just black. It's my favorite color. And you got to wear all white apparently, but I'm looking forward to it. It should be a fun time. You know, we'll see. And I know we're rambling on a little bit here, folks, but we want to say thank you for listening. And we want to let you know that we have a special episode coming out. We're going to be joined by an old friend, Mr. Dennis Bernstein, NHL insider. He's been with the NHL Network. He has his own show. He talks about all things NHL. He's an expert on the subject, and we're going to be covering the Philadelphia Flyers in the beginning of the season. We're super excited for this season, and we're going to try to break it all down for you. If you have any questions or anything that you want us to bring up with Dennis, with DB, let us know, and we'll bring it up with him. And we're super excited for this episode, Timmy. I know you were friends with him and reached out, and we can't say how happy we are to have him on the show again. I mean, this guy's a real professional. He knows his stuff in and out. He's got a lot of insider information. And for all the Flyers fans out there, I think you're gonna get a lot of knowledge maybe you didn't have going into this season.
Yeah, we're pumped out about having Dennis on, and he's our almost like Tommy. He's our NHL insider. You know, we got our own insider.
We got our own insider. It's nice to have someone on the inside.
Yeah, and it's cool because last year we had him on right before the trade deadline, and yeah, we asked him to make a prediction on what would happen with the playoffs, and he correctly predicted that the Florida Panthers would go on and win the Stanley Cup, which did happen. And we're going to try to get him to commit to a prediction probably again before the season starts. And we know how these things go, but he's going to evaluate the Flyers for us, and he's going to dive into a lot of things that is NHL. We'll probably have him on for about a half hour or so and just kind of bop around the league a little bit and really kind of focus in on what's going on with the Flyers. Cause he, like Tom said, he is well-rounded in and the NHL world and knows exactly what happens within that league. So looking forward to having him on.
Yeah, and be on the lookout there. This is to all the Flyers fans out there. And if you're anything like us, we know you love all Philadelphia sports teams, and we cannot wait. I mean, I am just praying for playoff hockey this year in Philadelphia, please. And we're going to break the season down, headed into the new NHL season with some exciting new players. Look out for that episode coming out. Flyers breakdown with NHL insider Dennis Bernstein. So keep a lookout for it. All right. One last thing before we get into our first topic. Remember, if you want to be a part of the show, the best way to do it is to give us a call on our hotline. You can leave a message. I know Timmy was fired up after the Phillies game today. He's trying to leave a message on WIP, but couldn't get through. You can always get through at Schmidt Lavelle, and you give that call, 215-948-6546, 215-948-6546. Give us a rant. Give us a rave. Tell us a story. Ask us a question. Give us a topic to bring up. Whatever it may be, give us a call, 215-948-6546, and we will play it on the show. We love your calls, and we appreciate you doing it. Timmy, let's get to something that I was thinking about the other day. Now,
Willies.
we're going to try to do this episode. We're not happy with the Phillies. We have a if you want to hear us rant about game three of the Phillies, there is a about a 25-minute episode available now on
Did we
all
go that
our,
long? Did we go
you know, it, there was a lot to cover, Timmy, and we're
that long?
upset. And if you're out there listening to this and you're in the Philadelphia area, believe me, we feel your pain. But so I'm out there, and my diet has changed a lot recently. I don't know if you noticed, I'm down a couple lbs. I'm feeling a little bit more healthy. Not that I was ever really a big guy, but I've noticed that I've lost some pounds, and a lot of it has to do with what I'm eating, and maybe not eating as much, but try to do a little bit more protein, a little more veggie, a little more fruit, and less, you know, of the
Shit.
snacking. I'm always eating the shit. I love eating shit. I love the shit. I love eating it, you know, chips, dips, candies, ice cream, cakes, pizzas, whatever it may be. I love it all. And I've decided, no, I don't need it. I'm not having it for now. However, I was at work, and I thought, let me get something that's a snack. And not that it's the healthiest thing. I know there's a lot of sodium. I know there's a bunch of different stuff, but I thought, maybe I get some beef jerky. You a beef jerky guy, Tim? You like
I
some
am.
jerky?
Love the jerky.
So I got this one. I think it's called Old Tafford.
Ooh,
Old
the old tapper.
yeah, Old
Old
Tafford, the
trapper. Old
spicy Old
trapper.
Trapper.
Yeah.
And let me tell you something. Jack Links can kick rocks. They
Yeah.
stink compared to Old Trapper. But I gotta ask you, they had a bag, and you know, maybe it's a 16-ounce bag. I don't know. How much is a 16-ounce bag? And I'm saying that it was, you know, a fairly good size bag. But I mean, Timmy, you probably know it, like when it comes to jerky, once I start, I can't stop. Next thing you know, I'm eating the whole bag of jerky. And here, hold on, I got my assistant here with me now,
Oh,
and
hello.
she's gonna throw it over. Whoa, ow, ow. Look at those hands. Look at that skills. Old Trapper. There it is. I'm holding it up there, and this was
Oh, the
a
hot and spicy has the crushed red pepper
oh,
flakes in there.
so
Yeah.
good. I can't recommend this enough. It's so good. 10 ounces. 10-ounce bag. Timmy, how much for a 10-ounce bag of
Tom,
Old Trapper hot and spicy?
depends on where you bought it.
Okay.
Did you
Let's
buy it
get.
at Wawa?
No. No. I did not buy it at
I
Wawa.
believe at Wawa, a 10-ounce bag of jerky is $17.99.
This bag here that I purchased was $20.
Maybe it was $20.
$20 for 10 ounces of jerky. Tim,
It's good jerky.
it's great jerky, but I feel like a jerk getting that. And you go up to the register. Do you ever feel this shame? You go to the register, you go to buy something, and you're like, you don't necessarily know the price of it. And then it's like, oh, wait, and then I'm there. And it's the shame. Well, I can't put it back now. I've already rung it in. I'm already up here. I'm already inconveniencing this person that I'm trying to purchase something at their business already. I just, the price of jerky has to go down. You know, there's a lot of things that people are talking about in this campaign. this campaign going right now. I want to know which candidate is going to lower the price of jerky.
It's
which jerk's going to lower the jerk?
It's not good. It's not
when
ideal.
When you bring immigrants into this country, the jerky prices soar. It's
you
flooded
gotta find
with the jerky market.
Tom, you got to find it. You got to find it. A local guy.
A local jerker?
Yeah, you got to find a local jerk.
Who are the jerkers that make this jerky? I got to meet a jerker.
They're
is that what you're
in,
calling? Is that what they are? I think the official
no,
term for someone that
you
makes
got to find a mountain
a
man. There's mountain men that love making jerky, beef jerky. They make their own jerky. You got to find a guy like that. I went to college with a bunch of these guys, and this is the first time I ever found out what venison was. They're like, you want some venison jerky? I was like, what the hell is that? Sounds like something in the Middle Ages.
Yeah.
I don't want it. It sounds old. I don't want any of that. And then
there were no utensils in medieval times. Hence, there are no utensils at medieval times. Would you
right.
like a refill on your Pepsi?
Yes.
Name that movie.
I don't know what that was.
Cable Guy.
Cable Guy.
Cable Guy. So you had the mountain
Welcome
man giving you
to medieval times.
Can I get a fork and a knife? Sir, there were no utensils in medieval times. Hence, there are no utensils at medieval times. Would you like a refill on your Pepsi? So you're telling me there was Pepsi in medieval times? Sorry.
Where
Mountain
we
man, he made you some venison jerky.
Yes. And I never ate it because I found out the venison was deer and I didn't want to eat deer.
Have
Just
you
felt like,
tried deer since or no?
Nope.
Never
Nope.
had deer. Never had venison?
No. I'm on venison.
You know, it's funny when you get to those kinds of meats, you get to people, they'll tell you it's gamey. It tastes gamey, whatever the fuck that means.
Like
Do you ever have
rabbit. Duck.
What's the salami?
Tom, have you ever been on a duck hunt before?
No, I've never hunted in my life.
Oh man, dude, you should
Except for
try.
pussy. And let me tell you, I might as well have been the king of the jungle.
You're entering the lion's den.
Yeah, actually, when it comes to that, I'm like the guy with like the bow and arrows, and then like there's people out there that have like machine guns.
He said pussy.
And I've never hunted before. Fished. I've recently really found a liking for fishing. I'll probably try to do that a couple times a year yet, but no, never hunted. I'm trying to think of the salami that it tastes like. I would say gamey. It's like a darker, like purple looking. Whatever. All I can think of is Genoa. But that's not it. Genoa.
Yeah, dude, you've never went duck hunting before?
I mean, I played Duck Hunt on my Nintendo. That's it. Is that
that's right,
that what you're
that's
talking about?
Right.
You son of a bitch.
I mean, it just popped right up on the screen. It's so easy.
Yeah. Oh, would you stand right next to the TV too?
Yeah.
Some people
Well,
I'd be like, boom, 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 and it's like they're right there.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
it's awful.
After a little while, it got old.
So what about Timmy? We're talking about the prices now too. I went to a deli the other day, and same thing with this diet. I said, let me get something, it's low carb. I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna get some tuna salad in a container. And I'll eat that for lunch, and I'll have some other, you know, stuff with it. And for a pound of tuna salad, any guesses? Are you a tuna guy? You like tuna? No. Tim,
love tuna.
1 pound of tuna salad, $14.50.
Wait,
canned tuna with a little bit of mayo in it. I know you're not a mayo guy, but they
is
didn't
that
have any celery. They didn't have any onion. There was nothing in this salt, pepper, nothing. They literally opened the can, dumped it out, put some mayo in it. That's all that was in this tuna.
Was it chicken of the sea?
I don't even, I can't tell you what brand it was. It was behind the counter,
Ugh.
you know. I didn't actually see them make it, but that's all that was in there.
Not good. Not good.
14.50 for tuna. Like a can of tuna is like $2. You can tune a piano, but you can't tune a fish.
Dude, that's not good.
The prices of things are getting a little out of control, Timmy. The
What
food
it,
is out of control.
yeah, I remember last week I went to Wawa and I was gonna get like a little chicken wrap. And I was like, you know what, I'll get a grilled chicken wrap. You know, I just wanna
Nice.
and like look, a wrap is whatever. It's like it's still bread and it's still carbs and all that
It's
stuff,
when we're
but
telling ourselves we're being healthy. You know
yeah.
what? Make it a cheesesteak
Yeah.
wrap. It's great for me now.
Right. So I was like, yeah, I'll get grilled chicken wrap. So I went grilled chicken and then like I threw I don't know, I like whatever. At the very end, I like went to like check out and the price was like $11 and like 80 cents. And I'm like, what the fuck? And then I looked over at the menu and it said classic hoagies are
Oh
$6.
my
And
gosh.
I was like, fuck that. I'm going, I don't want grilled chicken hoagie.
Yeah.
Like, why
Wait,
would I?
because it was the same thing, but instead of in a wrap, you got it a hoagie. And so
Yeah.
the bread, that's insanity.
Yeah, it was six. Well, it was $6.99. I'm sorry. It was $6.99 for a classic
6.99 as opposed to 11 something.
to 11.80. I was like,
Wow.
dude, this is ridiculous. Why would I? Like, it just makes no sense.
Yeah. You know what? And that's the thing. If we can restate that, Timmy, I kind of want to break down the wrap. The wrap is an interesting thing. I love a good wrap. I love a good wrap. Wrapper's delight, you know, you can do whatever you want. You could have turkey in there, you could have
Hip
chicken in
hop,
there, you can have
hippity
beef in
dippity
there,
hippity hip
you could,
hip hop, you don't stop
and
the
you don't
rockin' of the
stop.
bang bang bang, they
Yes.
jump jump to the boogie,
To
the
the
boogie,
rhythm
the
of the
boogie, the
boogie beat. But
boogie.
the best thing about the wrap and all the things that you can put in it is convincing yourself that it's somehow healthier than something else. You know what I mean? You eat that wrap and you go, you know what? What'd you have for, if someone said to you, what'd you have for lunch today? And you said, oh, I had a cheesesteak. And they're like, oh man, you know, let's try to get something good, you know, something healthy in you. And then that same person said, hey, what'd you have for lunch today? Say you put that cheesesteak in a wrap and you said, oh, I had a wrap for lunch. Oh, all right, good. Good job, you know, way to go.
Makes you feel better about
It
yourself.
does. Does a wrap not make you feel better? Like, you know what? I did something today. I ate.
You know what? I think the panini has a little bit of that too. What'd you have? I just had a panini.
Panini.
Oh,
Yeah.
you kind of. You even took it light today at
You know
lunch, huh?
what? I noticed something different about you. You lost. Wow, you've been eating these paninis a lot. Do you hear that, Joe? He's eating paninis now. Look at this guy.
He
You
used
better start
to
ordering too.
go.
Yeah, the wrap is such a it's such a fucking thing. I think people convince themselves that it's
Oh,
healthy.
I convinced myself. I don't know. What do you mean, people? I convinced
I
myself.
convince myself too. I feel
I'm
like
like,
I'm eating a wrap. Oh
dude.
my God, it's healthy.
I
The
was
fried
like,
chicken in it and you know, whatever else is going in it. Whatever. It's great.
like you go down the menu and you're like, oh, that has
All
lettuce
right,
in it.
bacon, fried
No,
chicken. Actually, let's
yeah.
do extra cheese on this one and blah, blah, blah. Put it in a wrap.
I love it. Yeah, you go down the actual sandwich menu and you're like, oh man, that looks really good. And then it, at the very top it says also in a wrap. And you're like, yes, that's it. That's gonna be so much healthier for me. Can I get
You know
extra
what?
cheese? Can I get extra cheese on that too?
Make it a whole wheat wrap.
Oh,
Jesus Christ, my doctor is going to be so proud of me.
dude, I go grilled chicken wrap with American cheese,
Bacon and
bacon,
honey
and
mustard.
honey
Yes, I
mustard.
know the order.
And I'm like, yes, I ate light today. I've really been watching the
Yeah. Oh
carbs.
my gosh. I want to look into how much carbs are. One of the things I do want to try to do is a make my own tortillas one day. You know what I've been getting into a lot lately too is these like flank steaks and skirt steaks and these
Ooh.
other types of steaks because
Yes.
they're a little bit cheaper than, you know, your rib eyes or your New York strips or fillets or whatever. And you can get it a nice one. And I'll tell you what, they're great. There's nothing wrong with these steaks. And it's all about how you cut it. It's how you cook it and you cut it. Have you done these? I mean, they're great, dude. I had one today. I had a what was it? A skirt steak and egg for breakfast. And it was like, this is the greatest breakfast I ever had in my life.
Tom, the Hilltown Tavern right down the street. They do a nice flank steak for you, for pretty cheap, for like $7. They'll just cook it up and they'll give it to you.
Shut up.
Swear to God.
Oh, dude, and then there's nothing like it. Like if you get it, 'cause so the key is for those of you that might not
Dude, I
know.
get it on Tom, I get it on a side plate. It's like, oh, actually, I call it a, well, they call it a side of steak.
Yeah. Oh, dude,
And
that's incredible.
they slice it up, and I just like if I'm in like a bad spot, like
Oh,
if I'm
you pick
coming.
up the piece and drop
Oh
it
yeah.
in. Oh,
Oh yeah.
dude, there's nothing better than that. And yet, not only that,
Yeah.
you feel like a man. You got your meat. You know, you take a bite of yours. Yeah. Let me get a plate of steak. You know, but for those of you out there that don't know, what you want to do with that steak is you get it out of the refrigerator, get it up to room temperature, turn your pan on or wherever you're cooking it on, high heat, put a little bit of whatever oil or whatever it is you're using it. Throw it on there, sear the one side. After a little bit, you flip it over, you sear the other. You want to get it to a nice, like medium, maybe a little medium rare, however you would like it. But the key is you cut it against the grain. So you'll see the way the fat, the marbling of the meat goes through it. You want to cut that against that. So cut that in half, basically, and it makes it nice and tender. So you don't need to get these steaks that have to be tender, a fillet or whatever. These other ones are just as good, and you put the seasoning on them that you like, and they're delicious. Little pro tip that we've learned from the mountain men that get the venison.
That's right.
Timmy, I wanna have you try some venison one day, you know?
I'm in the process of trying to make my father a shit on the shingle from scratch.
Oh.
But
Is he a big fan of that?
he loves it. He loves
I love shit on a shingle too.
it's his favorite breakfast. Just he loves it.
Schmidt on a shingle.
That's right. And I mentioned this to a buddy of mine. He's a friend of the show. His name's Colin Goshert, and he mentioned to me that he has some venison that would work better than the actual dried beef that is usually used in the shit on the shingle,
Huh. You know what I'm gonna have
which
to do? I'm gonna have to go to the butcher.
is cream chip beef, if
Cream chip
I
beef,
mean.
yeah. On top
But
of toast, right? Or does he do it on top of potatoes? How does he do it?
nah, he does it on top of toast. Yeah.
Oh, dude. I like the home fries right there next to it. Let it all get on. I throw a little hot sauce on there. But I could go to the butcher and ask him, like, what would because yeah, I don't know what the type of beef to even use if you wanted to make it for yourself. I've only ever seen it come like you get the package out of the freezer and you use that. You know what I
It's
mean?
a dried, so I researched it. It's a dried beef that's actually in the aisle.
Huh.
Like it's like in
So it's not
I
a
mean,
jerked beef, but it's a dry beef.
yeah, why well, it's some type of beef, but apparently venison is a nice little substitute. So I'm looking forward to trying that. My dad's not going to know because my dad is a weirdo, and I made tacos for him in the beginning of the year. Oh, excuse me. I came out of nowhere.
Yeah, those tacos still sticking with you. So you made some
So
tacos for him?
I made some tacos for him in the beginning of the year, and it was the first time he's ever had tacos. He's 81 years old. It was the first time we ever had a taco.
Oh my gosh. And was it a hard shell or soft shell?
No, I made both. I just regular beef tacos, and he was like, oh, I never had these before. I'm like, it's just beef on the fucking
Oh my goodness.
guy's a
What?
psycho. I'm gonna miss him when he's gone.
You know what I love is a taco salad. All right. Like, now this is kind of what we're talking about with the wrap. The guy that invented the taco salad, another thing, like, you know what? We're gonna make this healthy. I'm gonna make this taco into a salad. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take the beef. And I'm going to take the sour cream and I'm going to take the guacamole and I'm going to take the salsa and I'm going to take the cheese and I'm going to take the sauce and I'm going to put it into what is a deep fried flour bowl
Not
and put
a
some
bad deal.
lettuce on top of it. And I'm going to say, you know what? This is a salad.
Not a bad deal.
Oh, man. Oh, man. All right. So
Oh my.
let's get to our next topic. And it's something my wife brought up to me yesterday. Now you've heard of climate change, right, Timmy? There's a lot of debate on whether or not climate change is real or not. Depends if you want to listen to the science, some people will say. You can make your own decisions. We're not here to debate that. But my wife was at work the other day and she was talking to a coworker, and the coworker mentioned to her the reason for all this climate change and all the crisis is cows farting. The gas that the cows release goes into the air and is what's destroying our beautiful planet, Timmy. What are your thoughts on that? To me, I'm calling bullshit. I'm saying there's been cows around on this earth for a gazillion years, probably more than there are now. How do the cows outnumber the cars in this world? Like, cows are the problem now? Cows are the reason why this is happening? Don't have a cow, but tell me what
No,
you
it's definitely not the cows. I'll say that.
think.
I mean, they can't be helping the planet with the way they eat grass and they do the whole milk thing and all that stuff, and at the same time be counterproductive and then killing the whole world at
Yeah.
the same time, right? With their ass.
Yeah. Yeah. They're literally, they said it's the gas, you know, and it's all this thing. And I'm going to tell you right now, I figured it all out. It's these, the government's trying to get you to eat bugs. And that's what they want you to do. They want you off the meat. They want you to eat plants. They want you to eat bugs. They're trying to kill you and ruin you and make you complacent. Diddy's having sex with kids. The world's falling apart. I don't know what's going on. The diddler.
It is wild. It is wild. I have to say, all right, Tom, I gotta ask you about one person individually that really has caught my attention over the course of the last year, and he's starting to resurface again. And I don't get this guy because he was one of my favorite people watching growing up.
Corey
And
Feldman.
no.
Oh.
Do you know who Keith Olbermann
Oh, I hate that guy,
is,
dude. And you know what's the worst part is he's like a part of the love that I had for SportsCenter back in the day.
that's
And
what I
now he's
mean.
just a complete jerk off.
What the
It's
hell
so
happened to
annoying.
this? What happened to this
He's
guy?
just a miserable fucking asshole, is
Dude,
all it is.
I've never done such a 180 on somebody that I don't even know. Like,
Yeah.
I didn't even like I a
Dan
lot of
Patrick, I love him. Keith Olbermann, I can't stand him.
yeah, Keith Olbermann was awesome when he did SportsCenter. He was hysterical. He always had like funny, witty jokes, and him and like Craig Kilborn and Dan Patrick, all these guys were like so good together.
Stuart
And then
Scott and like that whole crew was just was awesome.
all of a sudden, like I mean, I in the last year, I'm like, dude, what is going on with this Keith Olbermann guy? He's just out of control.
Yeah.
I mean, the dude is just a is a
Angry.
nut. He's mad and miserable. And I just saw recently he's trying to get Elon Musk shipped off into, I think he's trying to get him out of the country. He asked Joe Biden in a tweet I saw today that he was like, can we please get him out of here? Use your presidential power to get rid of Elon Musk.
You know
These are
what? I think
things.
he's very political. That's right. Now that I'm like drawing, like I've seen a lot of his stuff that's it's very hateful, and it is very funny how much he is, how angry he is, and just a jerk off. He just comes off like such a jerk to
Yeah,
me.
I don't understand why he's been such a.
And I think he's a Mets fan, isn't he?
Oh my God. Don't tell
Might
me.
be.
Don't tell me
Yeah.
that.
The biggest offense, the second biggest offense that would give you life in. So, Timmy, let's move on. We're going around here. What an episode this is for you folks, and I know you're loving it, and we're loving doing this for you. We're having fun tonight. We're trying to get over the heartbreak of living in where we live and following who we follow. And I want to talk about something too. Now, here we go. You ready for this?
Oh, yeah.
I want to talk about something here now. This is
Hey
what I want
now.
to talk about.
Hey
What?
now. Hey
Hey
now.
now.
Here we go.
What about I'm talking about age limits on things. I'm starting to think that the government should have no control over when someone is allowed to have alcohol. I don't think that should be something that they man like that they say, hey, you have to be this age in order to buy. I think that's something that should be on the person, and it should be their family's decision. I'm thinking about it a lot lately, and who are they to say to us that, you can't have this alcoholic drink? And that's not saying I want my kids who are 7 and 2 to be drinking alcohol. I would certainly say to them, hey, we do not do that in this household. I don't want to see you doing it. If I see you drinking, you're going to be in trouble. Now, once they get a little bit older, hey, they want to have a beer, they want to do this or that. Well, maybe you can have it here and you can see what it's like to have a beer, or you can do this or that. You know what I mean? But why is it up to the government to decide when someone is allowed to have alcohol?
Are you asking me?
Yeah, well, what do you think? Do you think there should be an age limit? Like, especially the 21. I mean, if you can join the army, you should be allowed to have a beer.
Nah, I totally agree with that. I mean, I would say 18 is probably where you need to be with that. And for that reason specifically that you I just identified, if you can serve your country, you should be able to have a beer.
Yeah. If you
Dude.
can go die, you can go have a beer or a shot,
Correct.
whatever it is. Now, I'm not saying to not do it without any kind of knowledge or supervision or whatever it is. If people are gonna like I said, my kids, I would want them to see what happened to dad on his 40th birthday and say, this is something that can happen to you, but even when you're not 20. So
I would say 18 is probably where you need to be. I know people,
but should it
kids.
be legal? Should that be the legal, like the government's decision? I feel like that's a good rule. Yeah, I agree. 18 is about where you should be, but why should they be mandating that? Why should they be saying you have to wait until then? I don't think that's right.
I mean, I think you're helping a lot of parents out at first. Like, I mean, look, a lot of people like to follow the rules. I also just think that like you when you start introducing alcohol, you really start really there's other things that come into play with that, like especially like at the age, like when you get high school really is something where you should be clear of mind, you should be able to operate and you know be. Oh, dude, I don't fucking know.
Yeah, I don't
Why are we
know.
talking
I think we
about
should move on. I think we should move on. You're right. Let's just get out of here. This is stupid. I do want to tell a story that my friends told us this past weekend. I met up with a couple of my wife's girlfriends. We were there, we were talking, and they happened to be down at the Phillies Mets game on Saturday. And they were there and they're having a couple beers, you know, sitting in their chairs in the parking lot, getting ready for the game to start. And there's a nice older couple sitting next to them. They said they must have been about 60 something. And they were talking with them and, you know, talking about the game. And these young Phillies fans walked by. And you could just tell they were kind of troubled. They were clearly, you know, they could cause problems, maybe were drunk, whatever. And they throw some trash on the ground. And the older couple says, "Why are you throwing your trash on the ground? Just pick. Put it, throw it in the trash can or put it away," and they shut the fuck up and they walk off. So the older couple picks it up. A couple minutes goes by, and this is to me, this is a very upsetting story. The kids decided to knock over a porta potty with a Mets fan in it. And not only did they knock over the porta potty, they knocked it over onto the door. So wasn't there any way for the Mets fan to get out without someone helping lift up the porta potty? Apparently, this Mets fan really asked for no pro, like they were not causing any problems. The kids knocked it over and then ran away. I want to get your opinion on that, Timmy. Is that something? This is before the game. The Phillies fans get the porta potty up. The Mets fan comes out and is covered in
Kaka.
whatever was in that porta potty. To me, this is a disgusting story in more ways than one. I think it's not human to do that to somebody. I don't care where they're from. And honestly, I would love karma to come back and fucking get those fucking kids that did it. What do you think? Mets fans deserves it after tonight?
Ask me that right now, dude. Yes, no, I mean. It's not where you want to be. It's not, no, it's not typical of fan behavior. Fan behavior. You don't want to see that happen ever. And those fans should be reprimanded and
What would
suspended.
be the fair punishment for that?
I would say revoke their tickets for preseason. Don't let them have
You're not allowed to
any.
go to any spring training games. Oh my God. Honestly, I think that should be jail time. I think they should go into jail. I think I'd say at least a 30-day sentence in jail for doing something like that. That to me is one of the most vile stories I ever heard. Like, that's absolutely disgusting to do to somebody. And I don't care what kind of fan they are or whatever. Just because someone's wearing another jersey to fucking in a porta potty, dude, I'd want to come out and start murdering people. Literally, I would be like, I'm gonna fucking kill somebody today. Like, that's as low as it gets, dude. Seriously.
No, look, it's not good. There's probably,
Oh boy.
I'm speaking from experience.
Oh boy. Have you knocked over a porta potty with
Not,
someone in
no,
it?
not knocked over, but I
I
may
felt
have,
like jokingly, like, oh, we're gonna get you. You know what I mean? If someone was
I
in
may have
there.
locked a Giants fan into a porta potty before.
For how long?
I mean, it was good. It's good 15 minutes. We did the whole rocking thing. It was pretty fun. But look, you know, I was young at that point in time, and yeah, there was a lot of fans egging you on, and You want to
I've
kind
done
of.
some dickhead stuff in my life, you know what I mean? But dude, to actually knock it over
Now,
is
knocking it over is way too far. Like, that's crazy. It's funny, but it's way too far.
I don't think it's funny, you know what I mean? Like, I really don't.
I
It's
just
like,
so like
especially onto the door,
the thing
and
that
then you're
pops in
in
my
there,
mind every time I think about it.
jackass.
Yeah,
Yeah.
it's
Watch
just
my
so.
back. Watch
Yeah.
my back. Well, it's before the game. So now you got this person that was down there, probably spent a ton of money on the fucking ticket, gets knocked, the porta potty knocked over onto them in the
Yep.
parking lot,
Yep.
and it's before the game. Like, where do you go? You know what I mean? And oh God,
There's
I hope it didn't get them sick.
team store. You gotta get right to the team store. Walk in with the towel.
You got to find the closest car wash or something, you know,
Yeah.
whatever it may be. But you know what? We're gonna you're gonna have to clean up, and you know what? We're gonna have to clean up the rest of this episode. That's gonna do it for us this week on Schmidt Lavelle. We covered it all, from underage drinking to porta potties being knocked over to the price of beef jerky. You know you can get it all covered here on Schmidt Lavelle. The greatest show maybe that's ever been. Tim, you know how you get on this show, and that's it. That's calling our hotline, 215-948-6546. We love your calls. We appreciate everyone that gives us a call. We will bring it up on the show. We will talk about it. We will play it. You will love it. 215-948-6546. Give us a call. Be on the show. Schmidt and Lavelle, tell us what you want us to talk about. Let us know if what you think should happen to the person that knocks someone over in a porta potty. Timmy, before we go, what do you got to say to all the Schmidt Lavelleites out there?
Two games left. Let's go, Phils. Please, at some point, win a game. Get a base hit. Score a fucking run.
Dear God, please help the Phillies beat the Mets. Winning this series would just crush the Mets. It would be incredible. I would love it. And so would the rest of Philadelphia. We deserve it. From your friends, Timothy Schmidt and Tom Lavelle. Also, last reminder, Dennis Bernstein special episode this week. We're going to be recording it. We'll be putting it out right before the Flyers season. We're going to break it down, talk about everything Philadelphia Flyers, our NHL Insider, DB Dennis Bernstein. Can't wait. Be on the lookout for that episode. My name's Tom Lavelle. For Timothy Schmidt, have a great week. Go Phils. We love you. Until next time, peace.